think I can hold all of these. There's a lot. And I'm a weakling. Nope. She can't do it. Love that for me.
It's Jay, and today I'm here with another unhaul video. I actually have quite a few this time around because it's been a couple of months since I filmed an unhaul video, so without further ado, let us get started. So the first couple of books are actually ones that I got double copies of for various reasons, so that's what we're sharing first. The first one is a double copy of a graphic novel called Are You Listening by Tilly Walden. I was sent this by two separate publishers, so we got two copies of them. We ended up reading them. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. I enjoyed it, but wasn't the biggest fan of. It didn't blow me away, and my rule is if I give a book 3 or lower star rating, it has to go to the thrift store, so that's what's up with these two. The next book that I have is called Her Pretty Face by Robin Harding, and this one I saw at the thrift store and I was like, ooh, I've seen that on Twitter, it sounds really good, I've wanted to read it for a while, we gonna pick it up. And then I got home and I realized I actually already have a copy of it on my bookshelf, and that's probably why I saw it again and was like, ooh, I remember seeing it, it sounds really good, I should pick it up because I already own it. So haven't read it yet, don't know if it's actually any good, but she going off to the thrift store again, and hopefully I don't buy it again. The next book that I have is 4 Dead Queens by Astrid Schulte, and this one I actually won 5 Feet Apart on a giveaway off of Twitter, and they were also hosting a giveaway for this book, and they thought that this is the one that I won, so they sent me this one, and then I was like, ooh, I already own this book, so this is awkward. So I have a hard copy of this, don't really need a soft paperback copy of it as well, so I'm probably gonna end up giving this to my friend. It's more of a new release book, so might as well send it off to her because she's a reader too. The next two books are ARCs that I was sent, but then I was also sent finished copies of them as well, so I figured we don't really need finished copies and ARCs unless it's like books that I am obsessed with, but I haven't read either of them and I'm running out of room on my 1,000 shelves, so we're doing a little clean out. But they are The Last House Guest by Megan Miranda and We Hunt the Flame by Hafsa Faisal. As I said, I have finished copies of them. I'm probably going to be giving these to my friend as well because, like I said, she's a reader, so might as well send them to somebody who will actually enjoy them. Now, the next couple of books are ones that I've read and gave 3 or lower to, so the rule is off to the thrift store they go. The first one is Sleeping Freshman, Never Lie by David Lubar. I gave this a 2 out of 5 stars. Was not the biggest fan. The next one I have is Tiger Lily by Jody Lynn Anderson. I also gave this a 2 out of 5 stars, and I'm pretty sure I only gave it a 2 out of 5 stars because it has Tinkerbell in it, and I love Tinkerbell, but it was really slow, really boring, nothing happened, not a fan. The next one I was really disappointed in. It's The Favorite Sister by Jessica Knoll, and I gave this a 2.5, I believe. Very slow, was expecting something very different than what I got. Was really disappointed because I loved The Luckiest Girl Alive, which was her debut novel, but this one was completely different. A lot of people on Goodreads say the exact same thing as me. They loved The Luckiest Girl Alive, was not a fan of this one, so at least it's not an unpopular opinion. The next one I have is With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo, and this one I'm really upset about. I gave a 3 out of 5 stars. It was good, not the greatest, but it said the line, I let out a breath I didn't know I was holding, I think around 3 or 4 times, and after you read it the first time you're like, one of those books, and then when it repeats you're like, ooh, no. I'm really upset about this one because the cover is so pretty, and also, like, I took a sticker off and it took off the whole cover and I was really upset about it. I know that a lot of people do really like this book, it just wasn't for me. So the next book that I have is This Darkness Mine by Mindy McGinnis. This is another one I was really disappointed in. I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars, I believe. Mindy McGinnis wrote The Female of the Species, which was one of my favorite books, in 2017, I believe I read it, and so I was really excited to pick up another of her books, but this was not it. It was weird. Half the time I was just confused about what was going on, which made me keep reading because I was just like, what the fuck is happening? But overall, not my favorite, so don't need it on my shelf. And then the last one that I have is Gigi Gorgeous's He Said, She Said, and this is her autobiography. She's a YouTube star, sensation, whatever you want to call her. She is transgender and this is like her journey through her life so far. It was cool because I've been a fan of her for a very long time. I love her videos. I think she's really funny. It's not something that I'm ever going to reread. I believe I gave it a 3 out of 5 stars. Alright guys, so that was my little unhaul video for today. Let me know down below if you guys have read any of these and what you thought of them. And I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye!